question is bonus for all of you. Onto. However, the question is find the set of values of a such that f of x is onto. So basically, your f dash x is your f of x.
Yeah.
But still, I'm giving bonus to all of you because this is generally a mistake which happens.
Anyways,
the process of solving it doesn't change.
Sir, is there any one more question?
Now, the function is defined from R to R. Okay. Now, if I make this function onto means its codomain should be equal to its range, correct? So let us find the range for this function by our usual method, take it as y. Okay, make x the subject of the formula.
So one question, sir.
Yeah.
Now, since a is in the numerator, irrespective of the value it takes, it won't affect the outcome at all.
Outcome of what?
Outcome like the value of y at all.
Oh. Why not?
Because it's in the numerator.
So?
The critical point is
not very. No, range it will affect. Why not? Definitely it will affect the range. Okay. Now for it to be a real valued function means it to be having real roots as x. The discriminant must be greater than 0, greater than equal to 0. So discriminant is b square minus 4ac. This should be greater than equal to 0. If you open the brackets, you get y square minus 2ay plus a square minus 4y square plus 8y minus 4 is greater than equal to 0, correct? Which means minus 3y square plus y 8 minus 2a plus a square minus 4 is greater than equal to 0, correct? Yes or no? Now if you see that the coefficient, this is a quadratic equation whose coefficient of y square is negative, means it is a downward opening parabola. You cannot stop a downward opening parabola to go to negative side. It will go to negative side. Correct? So the value of y would cannot be all real numbers. Correct? Because if it is all real numbers, that means you are allowing the parabola to go down and go down below the x axis as well. Which makes this greater than 0, less than 0 also. Right? So it cannot be always greater than 0. It has to be, it will be greater than 0 only for some few values of y. Below that, it will go to the negative direction. For example, let's say, I call this expression as z and this is y. You realize that the graph is like this. So only for your y from this to this, your graph would be greater than equal to 0, right? Else it will go down. So for all real values of y, this condition is not going to be met. Yeah. Hence, your answer is going to be none of these.
Sir, but because it's open downward, for all positive values doesn't
make sense.
Why can't it be minus infinity to 0?
Huh?
Why can't it be minus infinity?
They're asking the values of x for which this is possible. The values of a for which is possible, right?
Yeah.
Now, in this case, whatever value of a you take, it cannot satisfy for all real values of y. It is not saying, asking you the values of y, it is asking you the values of a. Are you getting this point? So, your graph of this, if your y has to be all real numbers, can never be always greater than equal to 0. Sometime it will go down. Correct? Hence, the answer is none of these. So, question number 61, option D is correct. But anyways, you are not affected by it. But at least you should know the way to do it. Next question, question number 62. Similarly, can I write GIF of 2x as 2x minus fractional part of 2x? Similarly, GIF of 3x as 3x minus fractional part of 2x and so on. Finally, we'll have nx minus fractional part of nx minus n times n plus 1 by 2x. If you group your x, 2x, 3x, nx together,
n into n.
Won't it become n into n plus 1 by 2x? Yes. Minus, you will have fraction part of x, fraction part of 2x, fraction part of 3x, so on and so forth till fraction part of nx. Minus n into n plus 1 by 2x, which will get cancelled eventually with this term. Now ultimately we have to find the period of this function. You know period of fraction part of x is? Period of fraction part of 2x will be?
1 by 2.
Period of fraction part of 3x will be? Now the period of the entire function would be the LCM of this. What is LCM of 1 half, 1 third, 1 fourth till 1 by n?
1 by
n. Option B is correct. Easy one. Next, question number 63. Are your duties over?
Yes, sir.
Tuesday.
Yeah.
With maths.
Chemistry.
This is over.
No,
what do you have on Monday? Their end is your start. What do you have in chemistry? Chapters?
We have hydroalkanes, halogens, alcohols, esters, and phenols, and we have feedlot.
Yeah, so much.
Yeah, and we have a very lovely teacher.
Okay, we have a function like this where f of x is cot of 9x plus GIF of x square by mod a. Now, it's given that f of x is an odd function. Okay. Find the complete set of values of a, it should be, not alpha, a. Cannot ask on this here. Okay. Now see here, this function is definitely an odd one, right? But because of this x square, this fellow will not allow it to be odd.
Yeah.
Correct? Now look at the domain of the function. Domain is from minus 4 to 4. So if x belongs to minus 4 to 4, can I safely say x square will belong to 0 to 16? Correct? Now if I keep mod a in such a way that this mod a exceeds this interval, can I say the GIF of it will become 0?
Yeah.
And then only this will survive.
Yeah.
Correct?
If mod a
if mod a becomes greater than 16, can I say any value if you take between 0 to 16 and divide it by greater than 16, it will give you the GIF as 0. Correct? So basically I have to sabotage this function. Correct? Sorry for using dangerous words.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, that's why you have to.
So your answer is x would be greater than 16 or x would be lesser than minus 16. Is there any interval talking like that? Option?
Sir, option B.
B.
Sir, but when the answer over, if it becomes 16, then it
will become 1. One is neither even nor odd.
It's option B.
Option B. Please keep checking the answer which I have sent you. In case there is a discrepancy, we will make a correction. Question number 64. So far, I have found things easy. Let's go to 64. Can I resist? Find the range of the function gif of 1 plus sin x, gif of 2 plus sin x by 2, gif of 3 plus sin x by 3, and so on till gif of n plus sin x by n, where x belongs to the interval 0 to pi. Now first of all, by using the property of gif, I can pull out all the integers from it. So this will give me n into n plus 1 by 2.
Since x is from 9. 0 to pi.
Yeah.
Sin x by 3, sin x by 4 and all will get cancelled.
Now can I say if it is 0 to pi?
Only the first one.
Okay. Only one of these terms would be 1, rest all would be 0.
Yeah. But now only the first one.
And that will only happen
at pi.
At pi. Yeah. Yes, sir?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but in one particular solution, sin x, like everything becomes 0, you get only any factor. As in, if you take.
Okay, that is one of the values in the range. The other is, this thing cannot exceed 1. That's what I'm trying to say.
And moreover, sir, from 0 to pi, if you start considering sine of x by 3 and all, for any value between 0 to pi, it becomes 0. So you can eliminate.
Except for one case, when you take x as pi, this becomes 1. Else all will be 0.
Yeah, that's what. So you leave sine x and sine x by 2. Apart from that, rest all become 1 in any given condition.
1.
Sorry, 0.
0. This also.
No, no, no. Sin x and sin x by 2, leave it, sir. Apart from that, after that you get sin x by 3, sin x by 4. All becomes 0 to the same.
Right. Yes. Yes. So, only one of them can be 1.
Yeah.
Other one be 0.
Yeah.
Okay. So, the max that this can go is, or the other value apart from this that it can take is n into n plus 1 by 2 plus 1. So only these two values, so write it as a set, these two values will be your range of the function. So your answer will be a set containing n into n plus 1 by 2 and n into, or n square plus n plus 2 by 2. Is this an option?
Yeah.
D is the option. So D is.
Sir,
next, 65.
Sir, can you send a soft copy of this bill and the CVP?
I have the CVP.
You send it. Can I discuss 65 one now?
Yeah.
Next is the product of all values of x satisfying the equation sine inverse of cos of 2x squared plus 10 mod x plus 4 by x squared plus 5 mod x plus 3 equal to cot of cot inverse 2 minus 18 mod x by 9 mod x plus 5 by 2. First of all, let this pi by 2 come on this side. Okay. Can I say sine inverse something minus pi by 2 is minus cos inverse something? And this can I write it as 2 times x square 5 mod x plus 3 minus 2. This is anyways going to be this bit. Because 2 minus, okay, by the way, let me clarify this. It will be 2 minus so here it will be minus of 2 minus 2 minus 2 will get cancelled, so it will become 2 by which implies x square plus 5 mod x plus 3 is equal to 9 mod x, which means x square minus 4 mod x plus 3 is equal to 0. Which means mod x minus 1 into mod x minus 3 equal to 0. Which means x is plus minus 1, x is plus minus 3. So the product of all the values will be
9.
A is correct. Next, 66. On a scale of 1 to 10, if 10 being the hardest, how do you rate the vector? 7, 8,
7,
8.
How much
do you rate? Yeah, it's around 6, 6 and a half. Eight you are saying, right? So two gap is left. Then we will fill this two gap next week. JEE Advanced is all about striking at the right point. You don't have to rigorously solve it. For example, that odd function one. You just have to apply your mind. When can I make that zero? That's it. Your job is done. Next is, actually now we are planning to have a test on a weekday rather than calling you on a Sunday. On a non-centum day, but on a weekday you will have it. So 3:30 to 6:30. Yes. You have it Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, right? It will be even on a Monday, it will be either on a Monday, Wednesday or a Friday.
Yeah, so that Sunday, sir, Sunday actually you can get.
Yeah, that's what, that's one of the reasons. And secondly, it becomes easy for us to manage. It will be in the last week of July. You will receive a communication about the syllabus on Monday.
So we'll have
full integration.
So phase test?
Till when you have done?
Again, phase test.
It will be a phase test. It will be having class 11 topics also.
Oh, the one
time. So we'll tell you the topics.
Yeah.
For physics, the syllabus is kinematics 1D, kinematics 2D, electrostatics, ray optics. It will be sent to you anyways, but just listen to it. Kinematics 1D, kinematics 2D, electrostatics, ray optics, wave optics, moving charges, and magnetism. Coordination compounds, alkyl halides, alcohol, phenol, ethers, chemical equilibrium, atomic structure. Maths. Complex numbers, sequence series, functions, limits, continuity differentiability, inverse trig, differentiation, application of derivatives, indefinite integers, till covered.
Complex numbers.
Sequence series. And apart from the syllabus which we had last week, Now this implies tan of sine inverse x, is it greater than 1 or it is less than?
Minus 1.
Okay. Yes or no? Now if tan of sine inverse x is greater than 1, we know tan is a increasing function, right? So sine inverse x should be greater than pi by 4. Here sine inverse x should be less than minus pi by 4. Correct? That means x should be greater than 1 by root 2, right?
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Here x should be less than minus 1 by root 2. But it cannot be greater than 1, so it has to be less than minus 1, and this has to be greater than minus 1. So your answer will be minus 1 to minus 1 by root 2 union 1 by root 2 to 1.
Yeah.
Option A is correct. Next, 67. In a triangle ABC, triangle angle C is 90 degrees. So let's say this is C. So C square is equal to A square plus B square. And it is given that sine inverse x is equal to sine inverse ax by c plus sine inverse bx by c, where a, b, c are the sides of the triangle. Find the total number of different values of x. So first of all, I can make use of the sine inverse x plus sine inverse y formula. So sine inverse is this. Okay. Remove x and say x equal to 0 is one solution. Okay. This is one solution. I cancel it off, but I claim that that is one solution. It's not like I have cancelled it off. I'm assuming it as a solution and then removing it. It's the same thing as taking common. Okay. Can I just pull out a c square? Correct? Okay, now I can clearly see here that if you take x square as 1, it falls into the formula of c square equal to a square under root c square minus b square. What is c square minus b square?
A square.
A square. So root of a square will be a. Correct? Which will make it a square. In a similar way, it will become b under root c square minus a square, which is actually b square under root b square is b. So it matches with the formula c square is equal to a square plus b square. That means two more solutions I will get from here, plus 1, minus 1. So all together, three solutions. Option B is correct. I guessed it. You could have squared it and solved it as well, but that would take you more time. That would make the paper actually appear like this. Which you might like. 68.